Okay.
This is Justin.
And Rob.
From Through the Eyes of the Dead. And you're getting
your
fix on
Metal Injection.
Justin and
Rob.
From
Through the
Eyes of the Dead. Together.
Okay. Here with Jay Dizzle of Through the Eyes of the Dead. Justin, you know, things are happening in the band. Guys ran into some bad luck recently with members leaving, new members joining, those members leaving. Was it a little tough at some times? Were you like, man, maybe this whole band thing isn't for us?
Well, first off, they didn't join. The new members, they were filling in.
Oh.
Get your story straight.
I'm sorry.
First off. And, you know, everything is going awesome right now. So.
It's all good now.
It's good.
It's these
we're reassuring, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, the key members are in the lineup still, so nothing has changed.
Key members,
you,
and Jake, and you.
I'm in the band.
Yeah, as of today.
I'm in. What's my cut? Where are my royalties?
You're not in the band then, because Extreme Music, there's not that much money. I'm sorry to break it to you.
Yeah. Well, I guess I figured that out once I started a metal site. But
well, there is until you have management, and then they kind of rape you for your dollar. And
But these new members, they're not fill-ins. They're permanent members now.
We'll see.
Oh.
We're working on it, dude.
Who makes those decisions? Is that you? Are you the boss? You the head honcho of the band?
Kind of, sort of, yeah, maybe.
So like a 75% chance that it's you.
A little more than that. 95%. A little more than that.
99.9%?
A little less.
99.8%.
There you go.
Nice. So, but I mean, like, it must have been a little hard, though, like, because the last record you guys put out was obviously really brutal, and there was like awesome hype around, and then all of a sudden things, you know, just start crumbling. Like, were you just like, what the fuck?
Nothing ever started crumbling to begin with, but
you know, you know how the media likes to over dramatize things.
No, I definitely agree, but you know, we put out a great record, but that doesn't mean we're going to put out a better record next time. I mean, that's
so you're saying you're putting out a worse record?
It's going to be even better.
Oh, okay. This guy's a little drunk right now. Before the interview, he's like, I don't know if I want to do this. I'm like, no, you definitely want to do this.
That definitely didn't happen. He's making up a lot of lies.
Yeah, and being
I'm probably going to start drinking soon, but as of right now, I haven't had anything to drink.
Yeah, it does not smell like liquor off his breath at all, guys. You know what I mean? So New England Metal Fest, you guys played. Now, there was a little schedule mix-up, but I still feel that you guys absolutely killed it tonight. And I feel that the crowd responded accordingly. Were you okay with the crowd reaction today?
Were you okay with it?
I just said I feel the crowd responded accordingly.
So you were okay with it?
Yeah.
If you're okay with it, then I was okay with it.
Oh. Well, is that how you make all the decisions? If I'm okay with it, then I think you should get rid of your bass player.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm not okay with it.
It's up to you, pretty much.
He's out.
No, I was definitely satisfied. It was really cool, like, playing to like all these kids, and like everyone's like definitely way into it. I was definitely
stoked.
Is this
your first metal fest? Metal and hardcore?
No, we did 2006 and it was awesome. Yeah, okay. But that's this was way more awesome. So
way more awesome.
So we're doing something right, maybe. Yeah. Kind of, sort of.
Yeah, and I see you're sporting a much heavier beard.
A little heavier. It was a lot heavier earlier, but I trimmed like an asshole like a couple weeks ago.
Isn't that like bad luck on tour to trim your beard?
It is, but you know, we lucked out and played a great show. So I don't know what the
karma's back on
karma.
Your side.
Karma. I won't shave again, I promise. Next time we do Metal Fest, down
yeah,
to here.
Yeah, it'll be like the drummer of Killswitch with like the really long beard.
That's a pussy beard, dude. It's going to be three times that, dude.
Three times that?
Yes.
It's on camera now. It's like a legal contract, sort of.
Fuck it. Bring out your dad, bring out your dad.
earlier we were speaking, we were having a pre-interview interview, and you were saying that you might be going back in the studio to record more new music with?
Well, we're going
to
do a couple more tours, a few more tours. We'll figure it out. You know, we have some stuff lined up. You know, we're just figuring it out, and then definitely going back in the studio.
You have any new licks going? Any new shred-tastic?
We always have new fucking awesome riffs for you
to
enjoy.
Hit me with it.
I don't have a guitar, dude.
You have a mouth.
That doesn't work.
I just did. You heard that? Look at that progression.
That's a solo.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll use it.
Oh, see, that's a drum in there, too. I'm very talented.
We'll use that, though. We'll definitely use that, yeah.
Would I get credits on that? Would I get royalties? Am I rich yet? What's going on? Where's my check from Prosthetic?
You got to talk to this guy. He handles all the business.
Oh, am I going to have to give him a cut?
Probably.
Yeah, oh,
rest
we do like
peace.
Megadeth.
Rest in peace.
Yes, we were just talking about that, and we talked about it.
And it was cool. And
we like Megadeth. What other bands do you like?
I don't like bands.
I don't like that band. Oh, wait, you didn't say anything.
What band are you in?
What band am I in?
Yeah.
Through the Eyes of the Dead. We
I
were just
like
talking
that band
about
then.
It.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, obviously, like, you're in the band, right?
Yeah.
You know, I think maybe you should. I think maybe it's your time to move on.
No, dude.
And I
we're
take over.
A great interview.
I take over the lead guitar. No, I mean move on from Through the Eyes of the Dead, and I'll take over.
To Killswitch.
Yeah, you move on to Killswitch.
Okay.
It's with the beard, and then I'll take over for Through the Eyes of the Dead, and instead of playing actual guitar, I'll mouth the guitar because we've just seen how talented I am.
Probably be for the better.
Right.
It'll probably be way tighter.
It'll be revolutionary. Yeah. There'll be so much more press for the band just because there's an angle. Like, there's no angle now. With you guys,
thanks a lot, dude.
Look, I mean, I've been in this business. I'm just telling you how it is. Maybe you need to come up with an angle, maybe a gimmick
riffs.
Of some sort.
Better riffs.
Better riffs. Well, I think you got
Are
the
you
riffs.
Serious?
You got the riffs on. They're all right. The riffs. They're all right. They're good. Now you know what
Where
else?
Where's this interview going?
No,
where's
no,
it going?
No, on the internet. Because
that's a bad idea.
That's where our website is. So, it's metal.
Do interviews?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, with bands. I know. Yeah. So, one thing I noticed during your set is during the heavy parts where it was a repeating riff, I believe they call it the breakdown, that all three of your the two guitarists and the bassists, you were all headbanging at the same time.
Synchronization.
Synchronized. Yes, yes.
Yes.
Do you guys practice that? Are you guys, all right, guys, ready, and what? Or it just happens out of metalness?
Dude, it happens. You're in the zone. You're standing beside each other. It just happens.
You just feel it, right? It's like...
No.
No, you don't feel it?
Okay,
you don't feel it when you're...
A little bit.
A little bit?
A lot bit.
Maybe when you drink a little more, you really feel it.
I feel it now. Definitely.
But you didn't drink yet.
Right.
So how do you... Yeah, you know what? I'm preventing you from starting to drink.
Right. Exactly. So, I got to get my pregame on, dude.
Yeah, maybe I should stop being so selfish. Let's wrap this interview up.
No, let's not. Let's keep it going.
Let's keep it going.
Ask me some important questions.
Some important questions. How do you feel that metal can change the world?
I don't think metal can change the world. I think metal injection can change the world.
How?
Being awesome. Metal injection on the Red Chord Tour, that was sweet. That changed the world. I don't know what I'm talking
about. This interview, like, blows that other interview out of the water. But let's end on one final note. Let's have you say a message to all your loyal dozens of fans.
Thanks. And we're fucking back, dude.
Smoking like a true poet. Let's get to Through the Eyes of the Dead on Metal Injection.
Bad idea.